NASA continues to take steps towards sending Americans back to the moon and beyond. After years of development and tens of billions of dollars, the space agency's next generation rocket now sits on launchpad 39B at the Kennedy Space Center. In a few weeks, NASA will conduct a round of tests to determine how soon the spacecraft can launch. Once NASA gives the green light, the 17 million pound rocket will launch the Artemis 1 mission with mannequins aboard the Orion space capsule on a trip beyond the moon and back.
This is really like the last big test drive to prove that the vehicle is ready to go and is ready for us to get the crew in there and start exploring.
NASA says it aims to land on the moon again and make history for a different reason, with plans to have the first woman and the first person of color to walk the moon. And the rocket could have never reached the launch pad without the work of thousands of people right here in North Alabama.
From development to construction of pieces of the space launch system, that work from those at the Marshall Space Flight Center and beyond help make this all possible. News 19's GREGSCREWS joining us now in the studio with more on that. Greg?
Absolutely. The Space Launch System was not only designed in North Alabama, it's also being managed by the Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville. It's taken a lot of work to get from the drawing board to standing fully constructed on that stand. Development of the SLS program started in August of 2014, and then after thousands of hours and billions of dollars, pieces of the rocket were constructed and tested before the entire rocket was finally fully assembled in December of 2019. But then the pandemic caused serious delays. It pushed back research, it pushed back testing, and now things are starting to move forward again. The rollout to the launch pad sets the stage for a critical test for NASA for what's called the wet dress rehearsal. In the beginning of April, crews will fill the SLS with fuel, run a full countdown, and check for any possible errors. NASA Associate Administrator Robert CABANA says preparations for the test are going well, and crews are ready to make any adjustments.
We have prepared well for this. It's an amazing team. They've worked really hard, but I'm sure there will be things that we discover, as we have with other testing that we've done. When we did the green run test down in Mississippi, we found some things that needed correction prior to shipping the rocket here to KSC for integration for test and launch here. So it isn't any one thing. Huntsville's played a huge role in that core stage for the Space Launch System in getting us out there. My friends in Huntsville, you guys are an amazing team, and that's what this is all about. Space is a team effort.
This first launch, named the Artemis 1 mission, will be unmanned. The rocket will fire the Orion capsule to the moon, where it will then orbit and then return to Earth. NASA says the goal of the test, make sure the SLS is safe before they put any astronauts on board to return to the moon. Right now, the target launch date for Artemis 1 is sometime in early June.